they've got you, and then the little ones can't resist it, because they'll you know, get just the bad words or the name that their name is getting trashed. You know, there's a lot of
pretty soon, any time that the government wants to seize some money of people's, you know, people are just going to be at a loss. They're just going to come up and seize your money. And it's not going to be just for these gambling things. It's going to be any time the government alleges that you did anything wrong, they're just going to seize your money. And it used to be that the banks would fight stuff like that. They wouldn't automatically comply just because they were sent a letter to freeze accounts. You know, and people would have notice in advance of the freezing, and so then they would file a lawsuit themselves to combat it. But once the government has your money, they got your money.
Oh man, that's terrible. So it's not only freezing. By the way, I'm pouring a triple margarita. This is how I cope.
Good for you.
So. They can not only, right now it looks like the letter says freeze, but they also mention that the accounts are subject to seizure and forfeiture. It means you give it to the government.
Right, and it costs you twice as much money to go after them to get your own money back, and so most people don't bother.
Oh yeah, because you got to go to court and all that. Now what about these? These casual bettors who are owed this money, how are these offshore banks going to? I don't know how this works, because they had agreed by contract to use this. Well, maybe I should back up. They owe them the money. I mean, by contract law, even though it's another country. Now, whether, you know, the casual bettor has any actual legal recourse is another question, because they're, you know, using an illegal service according to the law. But are they owed the money? You know, what does our legal system, would it try to get the money for them, or would it just declare that the whole thing is subject to forfeiture, including the winnings of any of the bettors? I think that's what they're saying.
Yes, that's exactly what they're saying. And the bettors can sue the company, but I guarantee you these companies are just going to lay down and file bankruptcy.
Yeah, once they get seized, they can't do anything, and they have to declare bankruptcy.
Yeah, and it scares away all the bettors from betting on these online sites now.
Yeah, you know, funny, Barney Frank's not usually a friend of liberty, but he's been actually pushing for legalizing online gambling. And it wouldn't be a bad thing. And, you know, the libertarian opinion says, hey, you know, it's a free transaction. Doesn't hurt anybody but the two people transacting it. And why not legalize it and let the, I mean, they'd probably tax it like they do, you know, every other legalized gambling form.
Mm-hmm.
It's another source of tax revenue for them, and it's a win-win for the gaming industry and bettors who do it for entertainment.
Well, I think the gaming industry in the United States is behind the effort to seize these funds and to scare off people from betting off using offshore casinos.
Right, because they want to keep their monopoly.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's. I guess I did hear that. I was listening to Reason's Nick Gillespie today on Freedom Watch. It was recorded on Wednesday. It's out on YouTube, and he's talking about that there's when he was talking about legalization or removals of prohibition in general. But there certainly is an incentive for the people that already have locked in the deals in Nevada and to keep out the other forms of gambling, so they keep that monopoly. Well, I think we need to bust it. Bust the monopoly. Bust the trust.
Even if it turns out that this is a wrongful seizure, that'll come out. That'll come out in the wash, you know, much later down the road. But in the meantime, everybody's going to be afraid to use the offshore gambling casinos.
Yeah, because you won't get paid. You know, you make these huge bets, and if you win, You know, you wouldn't, no, it doesn't matter. They're subject to seizure, according to this precedent. That sucks.